at 8. Her title launch is 1. Nothing but net for 3. Good, launching one. Bullseye!
Okay. Want to become a shooting machine? Drilling one shot after another and in prime time too? Hi, my name is Stan Kellner, and I'm here to introduce you to an inside-out training program that's been around for over 30 years, helping athletes live their basketball dream. It's called Basketball Cybernetics. And for now, all you have to know about the term cybernetics, it's the science that created the electronic computer. And because of cybernetics, you're about to discover an internal success mechanism inside your head that's in charge of all your habits, tying your shoelaces, even the trajectory and finish of your jump shot. Now, it's your turn to discover that mechanism and how to train it to get the kind of results that you want. Even with perfect form, many players shoot poorly, I believe, because of the wrong kind of thinking or too much thinking. The problem could be a loss of concentration or a lack of confidence or simply trying too hard, especially after missing several shots. The list is long, but the solution is simple. The method addresses all of these mental barriers head on. Now, with the help of the ultimate shooting method, it's your turn to live your basketball dream and become the shooting machine you want to be. Before you learn the method and lock into an incredible shooting groove, let's determine how good your jump shot is now with a game called Personal Best. Before we improve your shot and help you become that shooting machine, let's find out how good your shot is now. I want you to take the basketball in two hands, face the basket 10 feet to 12 feet away from the basket, toss it slightly to the right, cross over, and shoot. No dribble, no bank shots. Toss it then to the left, cross over and shoot. In this way, you're establishing either foot as a pivot foot. You're not getting comfortable just with one pivot foot. So face the basket 10 to 12 feet away, toss it slightly to the right, cross over, square up and shoot. Then toss it slightly to the left, step, cross over and shoot. How many shots can you make in a row in 5 minutes? Now it's very important to keep score. No bank shots and no dribbles. We want to see how your feel, your relationship is with the ball and the rim. All right, Rob, you start us off. Come on out, 10 to 12 feet away from the basket. Toss it slightly to the right and shoot. Then toss it to the left and shoot. No bank shots. Now, I know bank shots are important, but right now we're developing a feel of shooting the shot straight in. Toss it to your left, cross over and shoot. No dribble, no bank shots. 5 minutes. Your consecutive hits, how many you made in a row, is your personal best. When you miss, you go back to zero. When you miss, your score goes back to zero. At the end of 5 minutes, how many shots have you made in a row? Your best consecutive string is your personal best on your jump shot. The purpose of the game is to find out how many 10 to 12 foot jump shots you can make in a row before you miss, moving around the court within a 5 minute period. Once you miss, your score returns to zero. No bank shots or dribbles. Just keep shooting for 5 minutes to determine your best run of made baskets. The method does not ignore the importance of correct shooting form. The stroke is essential, but after checking all the obvious physical shooting flaws, such as balance, hand and elbow position, and follow through, you might wonder, could the problem be in the shooter's head? The answer is yes, and so is the solution.
From outside.
The ultimate shooting method does not ignore the importance of the shooter's stroke, but rather it keys on trusting the power of the subconscious and by developing three essential inner shooting fundamentals called focus, feel, and finish of the shot. Focus, sharpening your eye focus before the shot. Feel, developing a confident, winning feeling during the shot. Finish, producing a cool, detached, mechanical response to the finish of each shot, whether successful or not. Too many coaches believe that good shooters seem to have been born with the ability to focus, feel, and finish with confidence, poise, and consistency. By using the ultimate shooting method, you'll see for yourself how simple it can be to develop these three inner essentials and at the same time, train your subconscious to work its shooting magic for you, shot after shot. After you learn the ultimate shooting method, I'm going to challenge you to employ a progression of three shooting drills called up close, personal best, and beat the pro. Together and in that progression, they will fine-tune your shooter's touch as it fine-tunes your subconscious with a ton of made baskets. These successes will give your subconscious that I can't miss feeling it needs to automatically produce future accurate shots anywhere on the court. All right, now what we're going to do is show you the method. What we're going to simply execute is verbally reciting three words with the three phases or parts of the action of the shot. What you look at before you shoot, what you feel on the release of the shot, and how you handle the finish, regardless if it's a make or a miss. Now, Rob, there are two parts of your brain that you should understand, the left side and the right side. The left side is the thinking side, the right side is the doing side. A lot of times the thinking interferes with the doing. If you missed a couple shots, for example, you might feel, well, this is not my night. You'll say to yourself, oh, it's not my touch tonight. I just can't make shots. All right, and what that does is interfere with the shooting. So what we're going to do is get that left side of the brain busy and let the right side do the shooting. Here's how we're going to do that. First of all, step number one is, what do you look at when you shoot? What do you look at, Rob, when you shoot for a basket? Front of the rim, back of the rim, space? Front of the rim. All right, so here's what I want you to do. Toss the ball slightly to your right. Okay, catch it, cross over, and say the word sight as you focus in on that 2 inches of steel on the front of the rim. Let's toss the ball, take the ball over your shooting shoulder, and say the word sight, S-I-G-H-T. Go ahead, go on the court. Toss it, sight. Toss it to the other side. Get it over your shoulder and say sight. What you're doing is identifying the importance of sighting your target. All right? And you're attaching a word to it, anchoring a word. What's the word you're anchoring? Sight.
Sight. The ultimate shooting method begins as you fine-tune your focus by picking a 2-inch spot on the basket's front of the rim or the back of the rim or a slither of space within the rim or the nearest forward loop holding up the net in direct line with your shot. Your specific target is not important. What is having a quality of eye contact. It is not how long you hold the focus either, only how clear and how well.
Get closer to the basket, gang. I want you to really clearly see that 2 inches of steel, or the space if that's your goal, if that's your visual target. Say sight as soon as you target, and it's a laser beam look at that rim. Pure and simple. You're looking at the rim. Okay. Now the second step of the ultimate shooting method is to attach the word feel to the trajectory of the shot. Rob, shoot the ball and say feel on the trajectory. As soon as you release it, feel. Move around. And in fact, add a couple more E's to the word to get more of a softer shot.
The word feel is attached to the feel of the trajectory as the ball leaves the shooter's hand and follows a straight and true arc into the basket. Remember, feel does not mean the feel of the ball in the hand. Just relax and shoot an easy shot without leaving the floor, regardless of a make or miss. Recite the word feel on each shot's release.
All right, good, gang, go ahead. Feel. All right, now, let's combine sight and feel. All right, I want you to toss the ball to the right, gather it, sight, feel, sight, feel. Now, it's got to be a smooth, rhythmic shot, okay? Sight, feel. Sight with focusing on your target, feel with the release. Okay, go ahead.
This time, you will be leaving the floor on the command word feel. I want you to combine sight, feel, leaving the floor with a jump shot. Can you recall that upper body relaxed feeling you had when shooting without leaving the floor? Now remember that relaxed upper body feeling as you drive upwards to shoot. The legs power upward. The upper body is relaxed.
After a made basket, after a successful basket, I want you to say the word yes. In other words, I want you to lock in that sight, feel, yes experience. So it's sight, feel, yes. I want you to consider yourself a human computer, if you will. And what you're going to do is program sight, feel, yes into your hardware. All right, go ahead, go ahead and shoot. Yes. Say nothing after a miss. Say nothing after a miss.
By verbally reciting out loud three key words, they are sight while focusing on the rim, feel during the release, and yes on a successful finish, several dynamic changes are about to happen to improve your shot. One, you are immediately freed up from too much thinking or negative stinking thinking that interferes with the outcome of a shot. Two, you develop a smooth, consistent, smooth shooting rhythm. Three, you have a surefire way to program the subconscious with countless imagined made baskets simply by repeating these three words over and over again. I want you to understand that you're not going to do sight, feel, yes during games. You're only during these drills.
Successful shooting is no different from opening a combination lock. Unless you click the numbers in correct order, the lock won't open. And unless you apply sight, feel, yes in the correct sequence, you can ruin your rhythm and the outcome of the shot. Too many shooters look and shoot at the same time and wind up rushing their shot. You must apply sight, feel, and yes in a smooth, flowing cadence. If your shot is flat, add a couple more E's to the word feel. Sight, feel, yes. Sight, feel, yes.
Adding clear after a missed shot. Emotionally handling the inevitable miss is vital to becoming a shooting machine.
On a miss, I want you to add the word clear and replace yes with clear. Clear meaning, well, if you've ever worked on a computer and made mistakes on a letter or whatever you're writing on a computer, you push a clear key and everything starts all over again. And that's what you have to do in shooting. You have to successfully miss a shot. You must learn how to successfully miss a shot. Now, how are you going to do that? Well, let's take a look at the backboard. And what do you see? You see a white surface, a clear white surface. Now, it could be the back of a t-shirt. It could be the wall, a white wall. But look at that target, the backboard, and say the word clear as you look at the backboard. Ready? Go.
Clear.
Again.
Clear.
Again.
Clear.
What you're seeing is a clear surface. So I want you to consider yourself a computer, a human computer. And what you're going to do is clear everything after a miss. Look at that white backboard and say clear. Now you could use the wall, you could use the back of a t-shirt, you can use a white piece of paper. Say the word clear. Ready? Go.
Clear.
Say the word clear.
Clear.
Say the word clear.
Clear.
All right, face me. Be honest with me. I want you to miss a shot in your mind and say the word clear and see what happens, what kind of response. Be honest. If you don't have a clear image, I want you to tell me. All right, close your eyes. Imagine missing a shot. All right, say the word.
Clear.
All right, go back to shooting now and see how many shots you can make in a row now. Okay, when you make a shot, say yes. When you miss a shot, say clear. Okay, go.
You must learn how to accept and clear away your misses and move on without any emotional debris. A missed shot can cause doubt, concern, body tension, and worse yet, overtrying on your next shot. Never show a hint of frustration. Body language should always be the same after the shot, regardless of a make or a miss. So clear it away. Machines do not get angry and frustrated. Accept the miss and move on. Time to retest personal best. Now that you've learned a method, reciting sight, feel, yes with a made basket and sight, feel, clear with a miss, it's time to challenge the method's effectiveness with another 5 minutes of personal best. Compare the before and after scores and draw your own conclusions. Challenge yourself daily to beat your personal best score of consecutive hits, this time without a time limit. As much as time allows, keep shooting. The sky is the limit. I have seen players go well beyond 100 consecutive shots without a miss. And why not? They became a shooting machine, and so will you.
Now what I want you to do is improve your shot off the dribble. So let's do personal best for 1 minute off the dribble. Go ahead.
Personal best off the dribble. Since you won't always be shooting standing still, developing your shot off the dribble must be practiced. An off-the-dribble shot requires a different kind of focusing skill. Start playing personal best off of one or two dribbles. Vary your moves, direction, and position on the floor. Keep score. How many jumpers off the dribble can you make totally in 1 minute? The subconscious is a very reliable, robot-like device that activates your body to do all kinds of automatic actions like walking, talking, chewing gum, and shooting a basketball. It's your subconscious that literally is your habit maker. Now here's the blockbuster that will change your shooting destiny forever. The subconscious cannot tell the difference between a real experience and a vividly imagined one. This means if you will mentally picture a shot cleanly dropping into the basket enough times and attach a feeling to the image of the ball dropping in, as far as your subconscious is concerned, it is experiencing a real basket. Think of it. This offers you an opportunity to score hundreds of baskets each day in the movies of your mind, and all without a miss. You're about to discover that feedback is the breakfast of champions.
The mechanism that shoots the shot, successful or not, is the subconscious. It's a very reliable mechanism. Now here's surprise number one. Your subconscious works exactly like the great shooters do. I mean, I'm talking about Steve Nash, Kobe Bryant, Michael Jordan. All of the great shooters operate their subconscious exactly like you operate yours. They operate on a thing called feedback. Feedback. So, in other words, the memories of your past hits or misses. What you want to do is provide it with successful feedback. But here's the glitch. Unfortunately, if you're shooting 35% of your shots, you're missing 65%. So you're really programming that subconscious, that very reliable, very dependable mechanism with what? Missing more shots than you make. So what you've got to do is give that mechanism clear instructions of success.
Many players live and die on the outcome of each shot and therefore shoot inconsistently. The cybernetic suggestion? Eliminate the self-inflicted pressure by reciting affirmations during quiet time that empower you and at the same time keep you on track. I am a shooting machine is an immediate reminder of your goal of who you want to be.
All right. Now, in between the shots, I want you to remind yourself who you are. You are a shooting machine. You don't get upset on every response, make or miss. You're as cool as a cucumber. You're cool. You're detached, if you will. Okay? Sight feel yes, sight feel clear. In between the shots, I'm a shooting machine. The players are reciting sight feel yes, sight feel clear. And they're reminding themselves who they are. When you speak, your subconscious is always listening. So if you tell it you're a shooting machine, it will believe that you're a shooting machine, especially after you make a tremendous run of successful baskets. Who are you? 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 Who are you?
Another favorite is never shoot a shot to make it. Shoot it because it's there. Recite this affirmation at least 25 times a day. Learn to shoot with this attitude, being cool, detached, and in the moment. You can make it happen on defense, but on offense, forcing your game leads to an overtrying feel on your stroke. Acquire a let it happen attitude with a full, relaxed follow through. Never shoot a shot to make it, shoot it because it's there. Will help you eliminate that do-or-die pressure of a prime-time shot. An open look requires that you shoot, nothing more. Why? As it's been said, no one has ever scored on a shot they haven't taken. Just remember, whenever you talk, your subconscious is listening to what you're saying, thinking, and doing. It is an impersonal servant. It doesn't judge or care if you're right or wrong, or if the feedback commands are good or bad. Its primary goal is to obey them. So what is it that you are telling this powerful servant to do? What kind of self-talk feedback are you providing it with? Is your inner voice a voice of doubt or a voice of confidence and trust? If it isn't, start acting as if it is. The subconscious cannot tell the difference between what is real or what is vividly imagined.
Remember, when you speak, your subconscious is listening. I think three very empowering affirmations that you can use to become the shooter. Well, you know one of them, I'm a shooting machine. You say that to yourself over and over and over again. You'll change those rules that, if I miss my first three shots, the night is over. You'll change it because you're a shooting machine. It will trust you if you start trusting it and giving it the empowering signals. I am a shooting machine. I am a shooting machine. Another one is never shoot a shot to make it. Shoot it because it's there. Never shoot a shot to make it. Shoot it because it's there. What's that one? Never shoot a shot to make it. Shoot it because it's there. I mean, being cool, being relaxed. Never shoot a shot to make it. Shoot it because it's there. I am a shooting machine. I am a shooting machine. We'll all help you out. Now remember, when you use these three words, sight, feel, yes, what's going to happen is you're going to lock those words into the action. One, you're going to have a lot of rhythm on your shot. Two, you're going to eliminate a lot of stinking thinking. You can't think, and you're saying, sight, feel, yes. You can't say, oh, I missed my first three shots. You're going to change the rules. And not only will these words, sight, feel, yes, lock you in to
to a shooting group, what it's going to do is it's going to allow you to focus in on the shot or the basket very clearly. And that's a lot of your problems is shooting, is that you're too concerned about the result, so you don't stay with the rim. Okay, and the third statement that you've got to learn how to say to yourself over and over and over again is let it happen. Now, you can make it happen on defense. You can make it happen on a drive. But when you shoot, you got to let it happen. So, I'm a shooting machine. Never shoot a shot to make it, shoot because it's there. And let it happen. Repeat it over and over and over and over and over again. Your subconscious will finally, ultimately pick it up. You'll become that shooting machine. You'll learn how to let it happen. You'll change your rules around and become that shooting machine and taking that chance in the game.
Developing the shooter's touch, filling up the well. Imagine a large, deep water well with a ditch around it. Let's call the well your conscious mind and the ditch your subconscious. Imagine that each time you make a shot, consider that you're pouring a bucket of success with its feeling of confidence into the well. Unfortunately, on each miss, it requires that you withdraw a bucket from the well. If you fill up the well with enough buckets of success with many fewer misses, eventually the well will fill up and flow over with the confidence reaching the subconscious, the ditch around the well. When it does, it is at this point that your shooting success becomes automatic and you have developed the shooter's touch. So, let's fill up the well. Let's make a lot more shots than we miss.
Your purpose as a shooter, if you really want to become that shooting machine, is to fill up the well. What do I mean by that? Make more baskets than you miss. A lot more baskets than you miss. Your mechanism works just like Michael Jordan's, Kobe Bryant, Steve Nash. It works very reliably on the feedback you give it from your past makes and misses. The key with the program is to score a lot of makes, to score a lot of makes, so many makes that your subconscious becomes fully aware that you are a shooting machine. First drill that we're going to do is called up close. We're going to start off with no pressure at all. Then we're going to add a little pressure, and then we're going to add a lot of pressure. Because I want you to learn how to shoot with no pressure on you. That way you'll get a lot more hits. Then I want you to develop a little bit more pressure. And then finally, a lot of pressure. Okay? So, stay right here. Rob, get under the basket. And the first drill that we're going to do is called up close. Now, how can you make a lot of baskets, much more than you miss? Well, you can by making a lot of shots. All right, so it's part one and part two. Part one of this game called Up Close, I want you to keep your feet on the floor, relax, and do sight, feel, yes, or clear. Make sure it's smooth, move around, make sure it's smooth, sight, feel, yes. Basically make sight, feel, yes, or clear, one syllable. Sight, feel, yes. Sight, feel, clear. Sight, feel, yes. Sight, feel, clear. You've got to get that rhythm. That's the most important thing. If you fall short, add a couple more E's to the word feel. Or work on your shooting form and follow through by imagining your wrist 2 feet above the rim, dropping the ball in. All right, second one is uncoiling. Okay, toss it right and left and leave the floor. Keep your upper part of your body relaxed. Remember how it felt in the first part of this drill. In between shots, remind yourself who you are. Each time you say, I am a shooting machine, your subconscious is listening. Your subconscious is a buddy. It's a friend. It's a trusted relation.
One other thing I suggest, Learn how to let it happen on your shot. Remember the upper part of the body that was totally relaxed? That's how you'd be on your shot. So you have to really upforce off your legs and learn how to relax above your waist. You get that relaxed shot, you'll have a lot of success. And before you know it, you'll be that shooting machine. You'll surprise even yourself, I promise you. Now what I want you to do is see how many you can make in a row using the personal best game. Just see how many you can make in a row. When you miss, go back to zero. For 1 minute, see how many shots you can make in a row, personal best, go. Keep score. We're adding more pressure to the shot now. Part one, we added no pressure. I want you to say sight, feel, yes, and clear out loud. The key was remembering how relaxed you are on shot number one, which is basically just sight, feel, yes, up close with your feet on the floor. Now what I want you to do is improve your shot off the dribble. So let's do personal best for 1 minute off the dribble.
Personal best off the dribble. Since you won't always be shooting standing still, developing your shot off the dribble must be practiced. An off the dribble shot requires a different kind of focusing skill. Start playing personal best off of one or two dribbles. Vary your moves, direction, and position on the floor. Keep score. How many jumpers off the dribble can you make totally in 1 minute?
Okay, next is off the dribble. This is part two of personal best. Well, how many you can make in a row off the dribble? Say the words. Stay closer to the basket. If you're not getting the success you want, just get closer to the basket. Rob, you're going to play a game called Beat the Pro. Let's get pinpoint and peripheral vision involved too. Basically, what you're going to do is you're going to compete against a real great pro. I want you to imagine playing against Michael Jordan, for example. And here's what you're going to do. With your back to the basket near the foul line, you're going to toss the ball away from the basket. You're going to catch it, you're going to pivot, and you're going to go one-on-one against the pro. No bank shots. If you make a shot, it's a point for you. If you miss it, it's 2 points for the pro. 10 wins. So, Rob, you have to make 10 shots before you miss 5. Go. Who are you playing, incidentally? Steve Nash. Okay, he's got a bad leg. Okay. 1-0, Rob Hodgson. 2-1, Steve Nash. 2-2. Four, two, Steve Nash. Who are you, Rob? Who are you?
Shooting machine. you.
Who are you?
Shooting machine.
Okay, Mark is playing Beat the Pro. Now, I don't expect you to say the words sight, feel, yes, or clear, or I'm a shooting machine, while you're playing basketball in competition. Only during these three drills, up close, personal best, and beat the pro. Talk about bank shots. We're going to give you a couple new words. Instead of sight, feel, yes, we're going to use the word high, soft, yes for backboard. High on the backboard, leave the floor, soft, yes. Go ahead. Move to the middle, get closer. Get closer. Now to the right. You're using three words. High, soft, yes. Now let's all use the same words with Rob. High, soft, yes. High, soft, yes. Everybody, high, soft, yes. High, soft, yes. Ready? High, soft, yes. Ready? High, soft, yes. Lock those words in. High, soft, yes. Toss it to the right and left and cross over. Say the words out loud. Recite them confidently and out loud. Get closer to the basket. So I want you to go back and beat the pro, inside shots, toss the ball out, turn, face the basket, and attack the pro. Say the words, high, soft, yes. Everything's backboard. High, soft, yes, everything's backboard. Now, I don't expect you to say the words sight, feel, yes, or clear, or I'm a shooting machine, while you're playing basketball in competition. Only during these three drills. All bank shots. High, soft, yes. Who are you? High, soft, yes.
Your imagination rules your world, truly. If you learn how to discipline it, it can really help you become the person and the player you truly want to be. Your imagination. And don't anyone tell you that you're not good enough, because you have that internal success mechanism, that subconscious that will produce for you the habits that you want to be the winner you would like to be. But the key thing is to discipline your imagination. Now, you don't have to reinvent the wheel. Let's say there's somebody that has the skills or attitudes that you want. Well, why don't you model him? Why don't you model him and use key words? For example, if Rob, who is a great shooter, shoots, and I want you to look at him, and as you watch him shoot, use those key words that he uses. Sight, feel, yes, or I saw, yes. I want you to use, as you watch him, I want you to replicate the same, repeat the same words that he's using, and develop the same feeling. It's called modeling. Why not model the best? You can do the same thing. Feel the ball bounce on the floor. Come up your hands. Feel yourself strong and aggressively, but understanding that the upper part of the body is totally relaxed, as Rob's upper part of the body is totally relaxed. And tell yourself, I am a shooting machine. And if you're working on a driving move to the basket, why not tell yourself, I'm a driving machine. I'm a driving machine. I'm a driving machine. Whatever you tell your subconscious, whatever you give it in terms of software, positive or negative, it will produce for you an equal response. So gang, my challenge to you is find the winners. Model them. Use your imagination to feel that you're like them. Learn how to successfully miss a shot, and you'll learn how to make a lot of shots. That I promise you. The magic of the cybernetic loop. What is the cybernetic loop? Well, cybernetics tell us that if you take a word and an action, and while you are performing the action and saying the action and the word are both stored in your mind. Now what you have to do is simply retrieve the action by saying the word. So before you go to sleep every night, if you say sight, feel, yes, sight, feel, yes, you're not only retrieving the words, but you're retrieving the action. And that's very important. It's a great way of filling up the well. So what is the filling up the well? That's the point of where you become a shooter, and your subconscious is in charge of your shooting destiny. And that means you're a player. So you got to fill up the well, which means make many more shots than you miss. Many more shots. So if you want to become that shooting machine, you have to learn how to shoot 60, 70, 80% of your shots during a lot of your shooting experiences and challenges. So are you willing to do that? Are you willing to put the time and the effort in? It may take you 3 weeks of doing these three drills, up close, personal best, beat the pro, and creating a stack of made shots by simply saying, sight, feel, yes, sight, feel, yes. Let me assure you, you're going to be the only one on the block doing this. But you're going to be the only one on the block that is really a shooting machine. And now for the ultimate free throw shooting method. Imagine a trajectory of the ball going into the basket. In fact, if you'd like, you can even take a rainbow, create a rainbow with your favorite color in the middle. And now say the word yes. All right, now get the ball. Bounce it once or twice, but as you do that, say bounce or bounce, bounce. Either way, bounce, bounce. Eyes off the rim, okay? And then I want you to go sight, feel, yes on a release. Go ahead.
Yes. feel. Yes. Yes. Balance, balance. Sight, feel. Yes. Yes.
Make two in a row, Rob, and move back. You go do the same thing.
Yes. Balance, balance. Sight, feel. Yes.
Who are you?
Shooting machine.
Go ahead. Because of that cybernetic loop, keep shooting. Because of that cybernetic loop, sight, feel, yes, is associated with success. A feeling of confidence will grow. Oh, you'll miss an occasional shot. There's no problem with that. You've got to learn how to successfully miss a shot. So you've got to be detached on the release. If you make it or miss it, don't be surprised. Accept it. Who are you, Rob? Who are you, Shannon? As you make two in a row, just step two steps backwards. All right, let's shoot a switch with the feeders. You're gonna make two in a row here, Harrison, two in a row here, and then you make two in a row right back here. It's very important to handle the response of the make or the miss shot with an equal disposition. Accepting is very important. Remember, you are a shooting machine. It's time to act like one. I want you to remind you that you're gonna look at, imagine a trajectory of the ball going in. It can even be a rainbow with your favorite color in the middle of that arc. Okay, and then I want you to address the rim and say yes. Because remember, yes has been associated with a lot of hits. So that's gonna give you a feeling of confidence. So, look at the ball go into the basket,
yes,
and then bounce either once or twice.
Bounce.
And then sight, feel, yes.
Yes.
So, can a good shooter's rhythm, feel, and confidence be taught? With the help of the Ultimate Shooting Method, our three drills, the mental practice, and of course your reliable habit maker, the subconscious, you will soon have that answer. The major question is, are you willing to put in the time and effort to nurture a positive relationship with the ball, the rim, and yourself? Then you'll fulfill your greatest responsibility to become the best shooter you can be. So what are you waiting for? Go to work and start filling up the well. The best is yet to be. Enjoy your journey.